And now for today's Bible question. We've been learning about the resurrection of Jesus Christ. We learned how the women came early to the tomb, saw and heard from an angel, but when they reported that Jesus was risen, the other disciples did not believe them. We learned about the miraculous power given to the apostles as signs to confirm the words they spoke as being from God. Someone might ask the question, can some people still speak in tongues today? We know that many are claiming to speak in tongues, and churches often incorporate lengthy periods of time to the display of what many refer to as praying in tongues. If we just look to the Bible, and not to what we see happening in churches today, then we shall find some clear guidance to understand God's purpose for using tongues. The Bible will tell us that tongues were manifested on the day of Pentecost. On that occasion, the apostles spoke in such a manner that everyone was hearing the wonderful works of God in their own language and dialects. The result was about 3,000 souls were saved. God clearly was using this sign to authenticate the words of the apostles and to draw people to faith in Christ. Please note that the people heard and understood what was said in their own language. The miracle was that the apostles, who were men of Galilee, could suddenly and miraculously be heard in every language represented in Jerusalem that day. We also find tongues mentioned in two other occasions in the book of Acts. The first was at the house of Cornelius. This was also a sign to the Jews that God was saving Gentiles as well as Jews, and that they would receive the Holy Spirit just as the Jews did on the day of Pentecost. Again, we must notice carefully the purpose of speaking in tongues. Not everyone who was saved in the book of Acts spoke in tongues. For instance, when the Ethiopian eunuch was saved, he never spoke in tongues. He simply went away rejoicing after his baptism. When Paul was saved, he did not speak in tongues, and many other examples of individuals who were saved but never spoke in tongues could be cited. The only other occurrence of tongues in the book of Acts was in Ephesus, among some disciples of John the Baptist. These men had known the teachings of John, but had not yet heard about Jesus. When Paul gave them the gospel message, they also spoke in tongues. This, we believe, was to demonstrate that not only was the body of Christ to incorporate Jews and Gentiles, but also the disciples of John, who trusted in Jesus as their Savior. This would prevent any schisms in the body of Christ. Another reason was likely the fact that many Jews living in Ephesus at that time would not believe Paul's gospel message. The Lord provided this miraculous sign to help the unbelieving Jews to know that Paul's gospel was indeed from God. Paul would later write to the church in Corinth and tell them that tongues was a sign gift for the unbeliever. Teaching from the book of Isaiah how God used a foreign language to convince the unbelieving Jews. If we clearly understand that God used the gift of tongues, that is, speaking in a foreign language not previously known to the one speaking, as a sign gift to confirm the word of the apostles, then we can discern that what is happening in many churches today is not an authentic gift from God. This view can be clearly supported from a careful study of the New Testament. We also know that God required the early believers to use an interpreter if someone was to speak in a foreign tongue, and that only two or three were permitted to speak in a tongue during church meetings, and one after the other. This is not what is seen in churches today, where there is no one to interpret, sometimes more than three people speak in tongues, and all at the same time. Clearly, this is not biblical. Also, what we hear coming from people who claim to be speaking in tongues is very repetitive and does not resemble any language. Jesus warns us not to use vain repetitions when we pray. I know that some listening will find this teaching difficult to accept and will not want to give up their tongue speaking because they enjoy the attention and the appearance of spirituality that it gives them. If you honestly want to follow the teachings of Scripture, then I hope you will recognize the falsehood of what so many are claiming to be speaking in tongues. May the Lord grant us all good discernment and wisdom on this subject. The Lord is concerned with the salvation of souls, and that is how He used tongues in the book of Acts. So let's focus our attention on seeing people saved, and not on making meaningless noise that does not edify anyone. Therefore, tongues are for a sign, not to those who believe, but to unbelievers. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 22.